Hello everyone, I am Shivantika, legal intern at Lexis & Company for the month of June, and today in this video we'll understand the concept of idea and expression. So the idea and expression dichotomy was formulated basically to ensure that the manifestation of an idea, that is an expression, is protected rather than the idea itself. Okay, so an idea is the formulation of the thoughts on a particular subject, whereas the expression is basically it constitutes the implementation of the said idea. So while many people and many individuals arrive at this same idea, they can claim copyright only in the form of expression and not the idea. We'll get into the history and the purpose behind bringing this. So the US Supreme Court decision of Baker versus Selden, which concerned basically about the copyright over an account book. Selden had written a book that described an improved system of bookkeeping by a particular arrangement of columns and headings, which made the ledger book easier to read. And Baker accomplished a similar result but using a different means of arrangement of columns and headings. So what was held in this case was that the Supreme Court created a clear description between an idea and its expression, and the primary reason being the otherwise, it would result in providing an undue scope of monopoly to the copyright holder and would amount to anti-competitive practices if the idea only and only the idea altogether was given the protection. So therefore, there was a need to protect the expression and not the idea. So this was the main purpose behind it. There are certain doctrines that were followed in time. So there was this merger doctrine that on certain occasion there just maybe one way of expressing an idea. In such a case, as per the doctrine of merger, the idea and the expression are said to be merged and the work cannot be copyrightable. And then there is sine fere. In that, the court considers the essential elements and the features as non-copyrightable, since protecting these will effectively lead to protection of the idea. And such essential elements were referred as sine fere. Now we'll talk about the idea expression dichotomy in the Indian jurisdiction. So there is a case of R.G. Anand versus Dulux Films in where the issue of idea expression dichotomy came before the Supreme Court. So the plaintiff in this case had allegedly violated, his copyright was violated. The respondent argued that the theme was common, as common to both the plays, and therefore the plaintiff's idea was not an original idea. In conducting that, infringement was not established. The court held that copyright cannot be acquired over an idea. Again, the same was followed as US in India, but there can be no copyright in an idea, subject matter, themes, plots, historical or legendary facts, and violation of the copyright in such cases is confined to the form, manner, and arrangement of the expression of the idea by the author of the copyrightable work. This was one of the points that was given by the court in R.G. Anand's case. There were other certain points that were considered or given by the court, and another was that where the same idea is being developed in a different manner, it manifests that the source being common and similar bounds to occur. So when we are if we are talking about the same concept but in different ways, both our ideas will be given protection, because it's not the idea but the expression of our explanation or our way of explaining altogether, that is what is copyrighted in this case. Another observation was where the theme is same but is presented and treated differently so that the subsequent work becomes complementary to the new work. All right, and there is, as a violation of the copyright amounts to an act of piracy, it must be provided by a clear evidence after applying the various test leads in the case law of the R.J. Anand. So there was this another case of Anil Gupta versus Kumar Das Gupta. In this case, the plaintiff had thought of a relatively reality matchmaking television program and approached the defendant regarding the televising the same. So the plaintiff argued that the defendant had toppled his idea and implemented, and it claimed that infringement of the action and violation of his copyright. So the defendant said that it was only the expression of the idea and not the idea itself which could be protected under the copyright, and the court agreed that the idea per se cannot be protected by the copyright, and also ruled that the concept that has been the subject of the dispute is a novel concept. It cannot be copyrighted even though it is just an idea. So this is all in today's video. I hope you understand the concept of idea expression dichotomy. Thank you so much.